Welcome to the sixth All-Star Family Feud Special, introducing for the first game, the Love Boat Family. Gavin McLeod, Fred Grandy, Lauren Tweez, Ted Lange, and Bernie Kobel, ready for action. Playing against the WKRP family, Gordon Jump, Lonnie Anderson, Tim Reed, Frank Bonner, and Howard Hesseman. On your marks, let's start the All-Star Family Feud Special. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yay, Tommy. I'm happy to see that real people are here because we have asked for people from NBC. Bob Conrad was going to be here, but, you know, he's doing a new commercial, Bob. He's for a utilities company. You know how macho he is. Bob does this thing now where he dares a person to knock a nuclear power plant off of his shoulder. And Tuesday, they had a meltdown. NBC is going to make it into a movie. It's called The Hot Dog Syndrome. Now, the other thing, apart from all of these darling people that are with, we thought we had a coup. Because, you know, politics coming up in the 80s, we had, for about 10 minutes, Carters versus the Kennedys. We really did. Teddy was going to come on with his family, and of course the president was going to have his wife, Rosalind, Amy, Billy, and Miss Lillian. But we had to call it off in the end because President Carter kept insisting that Burt Lance play Fast Money for them. Remember, he'd gotten done. You're right, one joke too far. We're gonna have a nice time here. Here are my buddies right here, the Love Boat.
How are you? Good, Richard, good.
There's my dears. Well, how many times? Three times you've been with us?
I think three times.
Third
yes.
time?
Uh-huh.
I know them all.
Four times. Yeah. This will be our good luck time.
It will be. You could win a whole lot of money here. Yeah. I know them all. Please introduce your family.
We've got Fred Grandy, Lauren Tweez,
hello,
Ted Lange, and Bernie Kopel.
Ha-ha. Young Bernie, looking good.
Can I say something else?
Sure.
We also have a new regular this season.
Now, didn't that young lady, you're about to speak.
Who was on the show with you, Jill Whelan.
When I did the show,
that's
Love
right.
Boat, there was a...
I Love You, I Know. Remember that song
right,
you sang on
right, but she was your daughter.
That's right. Anyway, so the male was incredible, and she's very gifted.
Her name is Jill
Whelan. Jill Whelan. And
she's
sitting
right
in
here?
The audience right now.
Come on, little big... Hey. She's going to be your good luck charm.
I think so.
Yeah. We had a nice time. That's fun, though, because she became a regular after that show.
Mm-hmm.
Now, who are you going to play? What charity?
It's for the Children's Hospital of Los Angeles. And the
Neurological.
Specific area is...
Neurology.
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 For Sean Pocus.
And it's for...
We're playing especially for Sean Pocus.
I'm sorry, Doc.
We're playing especially for Sean Pocus, who's our friend.
A little friend of
your
ours.
Friend? And yes. That's Marva.
Hello.
Good to see you.
Good to see you, sir.
And you were the one who could say neurology. That's why.
Yeah, we were
knew you knew.
No, that's terrible. You get hung up on a word.
But when you get out of here with this thing in your mouth, it's very difficult.
Thank you.
You haven't said Noodles Romanoff.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Here's my lady.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good, thanks.
I did the Tonight Show about 3 weeks ago, and I asked for any one of those days, and I think you were working. And I've gotten permission from the captain now. The next time
May
I do
I
it,
come
you'll come on the show.
Thank you. I'd
okay?
love to.
All right. Here's my buddy Ted. How
hey,
are you?
How you doing there?
Where did I see you the last time? Was it Hefner's?
Oh, you were surrounded by a bevy of beauties.
Well, at Hefner's house. We
yes,
were doing
and I was just standing by drooling with my teddy bear going, Richard, throw one away, you know?
Why weren't you there, young man?
I'm a married person.
Well, there were married people there.
Dickie, by the way, you know, when we did Tattletales, you said you don't wear makeup. Now, what's that on your face?
Makeup.
But I've if you never know, been so shocked in my life.
In all fairness, you told me around the house you didn't wear hair. Now, what's that on your head? Here, my buddies, WKRP, bam! Welcome.
Thank you, Richard. Nice to be with you.
I know, he sits at home every 3 months writing one line to zing me. Yeah. I'm delighted to have you here. And tell me, please, who you have with you.
I'd be delighted. Lonnie Anderson to my immediate right. Tim Reed, Frank Bonner, and Howard Hessman.
We're delighted to have you here. And as this is your first time here, it's CBS, and what time and what day?
Monday nights, 9:30.
A little blatant, but why not do it? You're kind enough to be with us?
Absolutely.
We should. Weren't you on soap, though, at one time?
Yes, I did Chief of Police Tinkler.
Yeah, I thought you... What's the charity you're going to play for?
What is it, gang?
Greenpeace.
Greenpeace. Oh, yes. The whales? Yes. Boy, oh, boy. That's a worthy cause. Oh. Do you know that a picture of you is behind the door of our producer?
Oh, behind the door?
No, I swear to you, Howard Felsher. I know it, and he's just blushing. Great big, big, big poster.
A poster? Yeah. Oh, my poster. Oh, yeah. That's nice. Thank you very much. Thank you.
We've got the real thing. We're very happy to have you here.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Have you ever done anything like this before?
No, and...
Now, don't say that. You'll have a good time. No, but acting, and then suddenly you come into this. I just want you to know, if I can do anything to make you feel better, let me know.
Well, you have already.
All right, I thank you.
Nick?
Frank, what happened here,
please? I tried to lift a nuclear power plant up on the shoulder.
Ah! No good? Meltdown.
Yeah, meltdown.
Yeah, no, what? You
parachuting.
And broke a leg?
It's actually parasailing, and no, I fractured my back.
Oh.
Hey, it's all right. My pleasure.
Heal. Howard, thank you for being here.
Thank you. A pleasure to be here.
I saw a big spread on you in TV Guide.
Frightening, isn't it?
Not frightening. It's delight. We're very happy to have you here.
Thank you.
Come on, let's play the feud. Let's do it. All right.
We should rub our heads for luck.
That's right. We need any dulling spray?
No, you're fine. You're fine. Just want to tell you that 200 points wins the game. Whoever wins this, of course, will play the winners of Real People and Soap. Here we go. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers are on the board. You got to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Tell me one thing that you see and always think, someday I'm going to have one of those. Yeah.
Oh, my God. You don't mean me. Go ahead, Gordon.
Come on.
Oh, come on. Yes.
Well, it was a hairpiece.
Oh. We'll take a look. Hairpiece? Not there. Gordon, wide open. Now tell me one thing that you see and you always think, someday I'm going to have one of those.
Car.
A car for Gordon.
All right.
You got it. 57 people said it. You control it. Going to play, going to pass. Talk it over.
What are we going to do? Play it or pass?
Pass.
Pass. We're passing.
All righty. They'll play it out.
Woo.
Fred, what do you think? Someday I'm going to have one of those things.
I think some kind of a house, like a vacation house, something like that.
A nice house. You got it.
Off the hook.
Very good. One thing you see and always think, someday I'm going to have one of those.
A fur coat.
All righty. Is there a fur? There is.
How about a diamond?
Yeah. Diamond?
Yeah.
Okay.
I
have a diamond. Ted wants to see a diamond. Not there. First strike, three of those, diamonds. They get a chance to steal, but old buddy here is going to help you. What do you think?
All right, new pair of shoes.
Hey, Richard, can we have Jill play?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, is that truly your answer?
Oh, yes.
I don't believe it.
Cut out that bit of tape where I said he was my friend. New pair of shoes is your answer? He could be there, though. New pair of shoes? Not there.
Surprise.
What a surprise.
Come on, Gav.
Right. Two strikes there. Now, tell me one thing you see and always think, someday I'm going to have one of those.
A boat.
A boat? Yeah. Why not? You're on one all the time.
Yeah.
And congratulations, your show opened the season.
Thank you.
Number one.
Yeah.
Number two. It's beautiful. Now I get it all in. If the boat's there, you're all right. If not, third strike. Boat! You got it. There we go. One more, it's a clean sweep. If not, they get a chance to steal.
Well, let's see. Is diamond the same thing as jewelry? I mean, is that...
It would be, yeah.
The same thing.
Yeah.
I'm going to say a Learjet.
Okay. It's the only airplane. Thing I can think of. Yeah. An airplane sounds good, and if it's there, you got it all. If not, get ready, champs. You get a chance to steal. Airplane! Not there. Gordon, here's a chance to get $78. What do you think?
We've got it.
Come on in here and tell me whatever you've come up with. Someday I'm going to have one of those. What is it?
Swimming pool.
That's it.
Aha. Swimming pool's there. You get the $78. If not, the Love Boat crew get it. Swimming pool. You got it. $78. Come on, buddy. Come on, darling. All right.
Distracted.
We're already distracted. yeah, you just.
Not you, her.
No, don't. I meant, don't look up, otherwise you will become. You saw the way Gavin got distracted with Gordon. 100 people surveyed. Top 6 answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name a food people usually eat with their fingers. Yeah.
Oh, me? Popcorn.
Yeah.
Oh, me, popcorn. 5 answers. We'll beat it, Lana. Food people usually eat with their fingers.
French fries.
French fries? You got it. Right. You're going to play, you're going to pass. Talk it over.
Play. We're going to play.
Going to play?
Play. Yes, let's play.
They want to play. Play. They're going to play.
Play that song. All right.
Very proud of it.
Okay.
Food that people usually eat with their fingers.
I can't think the name of it.
Oh.
It's a porridge.
Porridge?
Oh, I can't think of it. It's a tapioca. It's like a pudding.
Want to say pudding?
Just fruit. Fruit. That was the second one.
See, I know I've let you down now because you're not at ease. He went for pudding and then changed to fruit.
Fruit.
All right. Fruit! First strike. A food people usually eat with their fingers.
Potato chips, Dick.
Okay.
Dip.
All right. El Dippo and potato chips. Not there. I cannot believe it.
Who took this survey?
Yeah.
There'll be other chances.
What do you think?
Fried chicken.
Chicken.
Oh.
Number one. I bet you. Uno. For Howard, chicken.
All right. Hey.
Number one answer. $62 left. 2 strikes on you and 3 answers left of food people usually eat with their fingers. Gordon.
Celery.
Oh, no, Gordy.
Celery. All right. Celery's there. You're okay. If not, Love Boat, get ready to steal. Celery! Not bad. 3 answers will give you a chance. $62.
Gotta be there.
What do you think?
Nope. For our Italian friends, we say pizza.
Right.
Pizza. Pizza's there, $62. If not, a big, big lead over there. Pizza! You got it.
Number 4.
We got it. Spare rib. Number 5.
Water.
Bread. 78 right there, 62. Let's go. Come on.
Makeup for that fruit.
Well, it was okay, because the good thing, that other thing didn't come up.
That's right.
Did anybody figure out what he was going for, truly?
Poi.
Poi. Ah, well, don't get testy. I was trying to... People all over the country were thinking you were a basket case. He really had an answer. Poi. Dollar values are doubled. Let me just remind you, the first family that will get to 200 will play for $5,000, and they'll be in the finals. 100 people surveyed, and the top 4 answers are on the board. The question is, name a famous animal star.
Benji.
Lassie.
Benji Lassie. You got it. What are you going to do?
Play.
We're going to play.
We're going to play.
All right.
Lassie from the film Hello, Poi. Famous animal star.
Ren 10-10.
Why not?
Rennie.
Show us Rennie.
Right.
You're going to pass. You're good.
Huh? Morris the cat.
Ah. All righty. If Morris the Cat is up there, you've got it all. You will then play for $5,000 and you will be in the finals. Morris! First strike, no problem. Only one answer left. I said, no problem a bit early. I came to the Celery Kid here. Famous animal star, Gordon.
Cheetah.
Cheetah, oh, yeah.
All right,
Cheetah. He was a big star, wasn't he? Ooh, 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 ooh. Cheetah! Not there.
Oh, I know what
Lovely
it is.
Lily. Oh. Famous animal star, just one answer left, but two strikes on you.
Flicka.
Flicka, boy, oh boy. Well. If Flicka's up there, you're the champ. She'll play for the money, be in the finals. If not, Love Boat, get ready to steal. Flicka! Not there. Here it is. What do you say?
We got it.
Okay.
Come on.
We think it's a four-legged one called Trigger.
Trigger, okay. I belong to a royal.
Royal Dale.
Yeah, they have it stuffed, I believe, in Apple Valley somewhere. Trigger's up there. You get the 186. You are the champ. You'll play for the big money. If not, Gordon, you and your group will go for it. Trigger! Oh, think it's Smokey? Number four? Flipper. Flipper.
All
righty. Hey, you got $62 there. You know we always surprise you for your charity. You stay here and root a mom for me?
Yes, we will.
All right, I need two people to play fast money. Who'll do it? Come on out. Who's first?
Let's go.
You go first?
I'm stuck.
Howard, going first. They're going for $5,000 right after we watch this. Congratulations. Okay, Howard got Gordon off stage, earphones on. He cannot hear us at the moment. All the two of you have to do is get 200 points. You got $5,000 for the Greenpeace Foundation, and it's a worthy cause. We wish you a lot of luck, okay? Give me 15 seconds, please. Name a month that is also a girl's name.
June.
A pet bird kept in a cage.
Canary.
An elementary school subject.
Geography.
The age a woman's figure is best.
30.
Something you serve with cake.
Ice cream.
Turn around, Howard. You're a good player. Yeah, no problem. You're good. A month is also a girl's name. You said June. Survey said 36. That's your measurement. Pet bird kept in a cage. You said canary. Survey said 38. You got 74. Elementary school subject, you said geography. Survey said zero. Two people would have to say it to make the survey. Didn't. The age a woman's figure is best. You said 30. Survey said four. You have 78. Something you serve with cake, you said ice cream. Survey said. Look at that, 132. We have a board, please. Beautiful.
Thank you.
Go on back there. Here's Gordon. Let's go, champ. Come on. You are 68 points away. That's all you need. I'll ask the same questions I asked Howard. You cannot duplicate his answers. If you do, you hear this. I say try again, you give me another answer, okay?
Got it.
All righty. Please remind everyone the excellent answers, with the exception of one that Howard gave us. When he stopped blushing, give me 20 seconds on the clock. Name a month that is also a girl's name.
June.
Try again.
May.
A pet bird kept in a cage.
Parrot.
An elementary school subject.
Math, arithmetic.
Spelling.
The age a woman's figure is best.
Anything over 12. 32.
Something you serve with cake.
Ice cream.
Try again.
Syrup, chocolate syrup.
Chocolate syrup. Turn it on. Make me nervous. All right, a month is also a girl's name, we asked. You said May. Ooh. Survey said 21. The number one answer was April. And then we wanted a pet bird kept in a cage. You said a vulture, I believe. A parrot, parrot.
Almost.
Survey said 30. Well done. Howard, canary. Canary was number one. You now need 17 points. Elementary school subject. You said elementary, you said. Math, I believe.
Yeah, arithmetic.
Arithmetic. You said it very nicely, too. If it's worth 17 points, you got $5,000. Survey said. You got it. $5,264. We'll be back with Soap and Real People.
It's time for the second game of the All-Star Family Feud Special. Introducing the Soap Family. Robert Mandan, Jennifer Salt, Jimmy Bayo, Donnelly Rhodes, and Arthur Peterson. Ready for action. Playing against the Real People Family. Sarah Purcell, Skip Stevenson, Byron Allen, Bill Rafferty, and Mark Russell. On your marks for the second game of the All-Star Family Feud Special. And here once again is the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
My buddy's right here. Now, whoever wins out of this, by the way, you're not going to play WKRP. They're already in the finals. We know each other. You're okay. Mm-hmm. You're not nervous, are you?
No.
No, I'm fine.
You're going to have a good time?
Oh, yes.
Let's meet your family, sir, please.
Jennifer Salt.
Hello, darling.
Jimmy Bayo, Donnelly Rhodes, and Arthur Peterson.
Hi, Richard.
Good to see you here. Who are you playing for?
We're playing... You'll be glad to know for the motion picture relief.
Oh, am I glad to hear that. You and I will be there in a couple
of
years. And we wish you lots of luck, and we thank you for being here. Here's a family going to challenge a call to Real People. Oh, I didn't meet him. No, I didn't. Don't do that. No, no. I thought, you know something, I felt so relaxed, I thought it was the daytime show. I got to walk down here because these are not my regular family. I'm sorry, Jenna. These guys I can pass by, but how could I have passed you?
I don't know.
I don't know either. Will you accept my apologies?
Oh, yeah.
And also this ring.
Take it.
Don't tell her to take it. How you doing?
Very good, and you?
I saw you. Where did I see you the other day?
A party.
That's right. Guess where this little fellow was? Tell the truth.
No,
tell America
very nice
where you were.
Party.
Where were you?
Playboy party.
Yeah, he
very
looks,
nice.
Doesn't he look cute? And there he was at Hefner's mansion.
Yes.
Have a good time?
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. No, it was really very nice.
No,
I just
he was very well behaved. He had an accident when he left. Somebody trod on his hands, but otherwise the whole evening was... You were with a pretty girl.
He always is.
We shouldn't mention it in case other pretty girls are watching, should
okay,
we?
Okay, right.
All right, do you forgive me for going over there too early?
Yes.
Okay. How you doing?
Hi, Richard. How are you?
Good, thank you. Did you get invited to the party at Hefner's?
Yes.
Did you go?
No, I'm married.
Oh. Well, ask a silly question, you get a silly answer.
It's not silly, buddy.
Arthur, we're delighted to have you here. You're going to play this game well, aren't you?
Oh, I hope so.
No problem at all.
Oh, I hope
now
so.
Help me. We've cleaned this up. Now help me. Welcome real
that.
People. Come on. Yeah. I don't want to get to you.
Well, is this our first date?
I can't kiss on the first date.
No,
you know
I can't
that.
Either. No.
I'm kind of proud of this show. Now tell them the day you're on. What time? Tell them.
No. Oh!
Well, it's only fair. This is an ABC
Wednesday
show.
Wednesday night at 8. Thank you, Skip.
Okay. I was at the very first taping of Real People last year. And then when I hosted the Tonight Show, I predicted you were going to be a smash and be back, and you are.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for not making me look as foolish as I made myself look when I came over here.
We did our best.
Let's meet them all.
Oh, we have a terrific team. The ever-handsome Skip Stevenson.
Aha!
Next to him, our 18-year-old Byron Allen.
Yeah.
Terrific comedian. And on his right, Bill Rafferty, our roving reporter. And on Bill's right, our Washington correspondent, Mark Russell.
Yeah. Hey, he's my buddy. How you doing? Who are you playing for, Don?
We're playing for the Amy Karen Cancer Fund.
Okay. We wish you lots of
luck. Thank you so much.
See, these I remember to walk down. There I pass. How are you?
Richard, it's good to see you again. One of us is overdressed.
Yeah. My invitation said black tie. What did you...
Well, I would have worn a tuxedo, but they don't come in band lines, so I... Huh? I was on The Tonight Show with you when you predicted that.
I know, and I remember you did a very similar line to that, Tim. About the same reaction. If I remembered, I introduced another guest very quickly.
Yes.
The newcomer to the show, nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
How did they find you to get on Real People?
They found me on the Tonight Show.
Did they really?
Yes.
Who was the guest?
Johnny Carson.
See, that's where you made your mistake.
That's funny.
You came on with me. You should have come on with John. Good to have you here.
Richard.
All is well?
Oh, it's terrific.
All right. Here's my buddy that we did a special a long time ago for ABC in Washington. Did we not?
Oh, Richard. Good to see you.
6 in the morning.
Yes,
you and I worked.
It really
90
was.
Minutes.
Yep.
They have never shown it to this day, have they?
As I recall, they were smart.
They were smart.
Things are a little more exciting now. There.
Okay. Ready to do this?
Yes.
Let's play the feud. Come on. Come on, Angel. That's what he was doing, charming.
That's exactly.
Yeah.
It worked.
All right. Remember, 200 is the magic number you're going for. Whoever gets that will play for $5,000. 100 people surveyed. Top 7 answers are on the board. Try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something guests do at a wedding.
Yeah. Cry.
They cry. Very good. One answer will beat it, Sarah.
They bring presents.
They bring gifts.
Yes.
They do indeed, but you control it. You're going to play or pass?
We're going to play.
Okay, she knew that. Very nicely put. No, we had one sound effect left over from the last special. I thought we would have put it in a little cleaner than that, but never mind. Something guests do at a wedding.
Eat hors d'oeuvres?
They do. Just eat would be enough, wouldn't it?
Eat.
We don't have to nail
eat.
Down hors d'oeuvres.
Yeah.
Although the hors d'oeuvres at my son's wedding, I wish they had been nailed down. Eat! There you go. Jimmy.
They kiss the bride.
Gonna give a great big kiss to the bride. There you go. Very good. Finally, something guests do at a wedding.
Kiss the bride. To give gifts, that's up there already.
Dance.
They dance. Yeah. I won't dance. Very good. Yeah, I expected an answer like that from you. You already told me you were married.
Kiss the bride.
Something guests do at a wedding, Arthur.
Meet the relatives.
Ah, okay. Here we have over here King Kong. The relatives. Not there. First strike, 3 of those that get a chance to steal. Only 2 answers left, Robert.
Throw rice.
Uh-huh.
Very good.
Throw rice. Very good. You know that plastic rice was invented because of the Gabor sisters? Say no, but if you hum a few bars, just 1 answer left. It's the number 1 answer.
Catch the bouquet.
Okay. If Catch the Bouquet is up there, you've got it all. Nice big lead. If not, just your second strike. Bouquet! Not there. Jimmy?
My.
Good try.
Something guests do at a wedding. 1 answer left, 2 strikes on you. Three seconds. Here's a chance for you right now. $58 there. What do you say?
Drink.
Drink.
Sure, if eat's up there, I would think.
There it is.
If drink's there, you get the $58. If not, we'll give it to Robert and his family. Drink!
All-Star Family Feud Special will continue in a moment.
Okay, real people, you got $58. Right. Soap has nothing. They got Jenny. Come on, Jennifer, down. Want to wish each other luck at all?
Watch out, Jennifer. I have fast hands.
You want to wish each other luck at all?
I would like to wish you all the luck that I could possibly wish you.
Seems sincere.
Yes.
Just remind you, 200 points is what you're going for. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. Kind of a long question. Listen, unfortunately, people lie. For example, we frequently lie to a clerk in a complaint department. Name somebody else the people lie to.
They lie to their boss.
Boss.
Late for work.
Boss. Three answers, Jennifer, will beat it. What do you think?
Come on, Jennifer.
Name somebody else that people lie to.
Their wives.
Wives! All righty. They're both worth six. You got it. First one revealed. What are you going to play
or pass? These real people are telling me they want to play.
They're going to play.
Going to play.
All right.
We're going to play.
Well done.
Whoa, okay.
What do you think?
Their parents.
Their parents. They shouldn't, but do they? Parents! Number one. Hey. Number one answer. Phil?
Very good.
What do you think?
I think we're going to do it. I think we're rolling.
What do you think?
If I could really think, Richard, I wouldn't be.
Okay.
I say... police.
Good answer. Any of our 100 people say dum-da-dum-dum. Police!
Hit it.
You got it. Yeah. Oh, got it. One more. Got it all, Mark.
Okay.
All right. This is, there's nothing personal in this.
No.
As far, I have nothing to do with this answer myself, but there are people in this world who would lie to the tax collector, the Internal Revenue.
They would indeed. I happen to know you wouldn't.
No, there are people.
I wouldn't,
no,
you wouldn't, and
I didn't
things.
Mean to say that you would, Richard.
No, I was clearing his
Richard,
thought.
Is it?
Yeah, Richard. I was,
yeah, I'm sorry.
Could you tell us a few of them?
If I have any more trouble, I will name names of the people who have. Don't get me
I'm sorry.
IRS for all the money.
Get it.
Nothing. Come on, Jimmy.
Hey, how's it going, buddy?
All righty, dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name something that makes your eyes tear. Yeah.
Smog.
Smog!
Yay!
Two answers will beat it, Byron. What do you say? Something to make your eyes tear.
Onions.
Onions? What are you gonna do? Gonna play or gonna pass?
Play it.
My team wants to play.
They're gonna play it.
All right, let's go. Hey.
What's the question?
Same question I asked him. Something that makes your eyes tear.
Horseradish.
Okay.
What?
Horseradish?
Get it.
Which
check
I think answers the question, where are the new game players coming from? Not from NBC. First strike. Something makes your eyes tear.
Pollen.
Uh-huh. Would take a look for little pollen. Not there. Second. Strike.
Well, the board's wrong. That's
Sarah, something that
check
makes
out
your
that
eyes
survey,
tear.
You?
Oh, I hate this pressure. Hot mustard.
Hot mustard is there. You're okay. If not, it is your third strike. So get ready, because there's two answers up there. We'll give you a chance to steal. Hot mustard! Here's the chance for you to get in the game. There's 170 up there. Something that makes your eyes tear.
Contact lenses.
And your answer is?
Contact lenses.
Contact lenses. Okay. Contact lenses on the board, you get the 170. If not, you have enough to play for $5,000 and you'll be in the final. Contact lens! You got it! Yeah. Yeah. What about smoke?
What about
I just thought of it. The only one I could think of is smoke. I don't know if it's there. Show me number two. Sadness. Number four, and smoke. Okay, we're gonna give you something to give to your charity, I promise you. Will you help me now, please? Stay here, root them on.
Yes.
I need two people to play. Who's gonna play for the fast money? Let's go. Who'll go first? All right, Mark, you stay there, you go there. Right here, champ. Here we go. I hope this is not an omen, CBS and NBC One. Sure, it's easy for you to say I'm at ABC. Okay, Bill off stage can't hear us. Earphones on? All right, he's all ready. We wish you lots of luck. We want you to get the money. You're playing for the Amy Caron Cancer Fund. Couldn't think of a worthier cause. $5,000 there for you. 200 points between you. Wish you luck. Give me 15 seconds, please. Name the crime you think most people are arrested for.
Theft.
A holiday to display the flag.
Flag Day.
The age people start losing their sex drive.
70.
A fruit you can buy fresh year-round.
Orange.
Something you feed farm animals.
Oats.
Turn around, Mark. Name the crime you think most people are arrested for. You said theft. Survey said 44. Holiday to display the flag. You said Flag Day. Make a mockery of it being anything else. Survey said 19. You got 63. The age people start losing their sex drive. You certainly made me feel good again. I thought I was on the brink until you said,
Well, you got till Tuesday.
Thank you, yeah. 70. Survey said. The fruit you can buy fresh year-round, you said an orange. Survey said. 30, you got 101. Something you feed farm animals and people over 70, you said oats. Our survey said. You got 118. Clear the board, please. Good. You did it. Go on back there. Here's Bill. Come on, Bill.
Okay.
You're 82 points away. I'll ask the same questions that I asked Mark. You cannot duplicate his answers. If you do, you hear this. I say try again. You give me another answer, okay?
I got it.
We are all rooting for you. We really are. Please remind everyone the answers Mark gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock, and we wish you luck. Here we go. Name the crime you think most people are arrested for.
Stealing.
Try again.
Murder.
A holiday to display the flag.
4th of July.
The age people start losing their sex drive.
35.
A fruit you can buy fresh year-round.
Tomatoes.
Something you feed farm animals.
Corn.
Corn, right on the buzzer. Crime you think most people are arrested for. You said murder. Survey said 2. Theft, burglary, number one answer. Got 120. We wanted a holiday to display the flag, and you said July 4th, number one answer. Survey said 57.
All right.
We're gonna do it. The age people start losing their sex drive, I had just gotten lifted up here with Mark, and then you really depressed me.
Used to be a waist size,
yeah,
now it's an age.
Running on borrowed time here. You said 35. Survey said, oh, 4.
You're not alone.
I know. 50 was the number one age. You now need 19 points of fruit you can buy fresh year-round. You said tomatoes. Survey said 2. Apples. Apples, the number one answer. Then something you feed farm animals. You said?
Corn.
The number one answer was hay. You need 17 points. Survey said? For $10,000, right after we watch this. We got the two big winners here. WKRP playing for the Greenpeace Foundation, $5,264. Real people playing for Amy Karen Cancer Fund, $5,307.
Hey,
Sarah, I need ya. Hey, Gordon, come on, sir. All right. Now, this is our very special round. It's just one question. Whoever wins it will play for $10,000. And Gordon, even though you're handsome, just one hand. Which one? Okay. All righty. Here we go. 100 people surveyed. The top 6 answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name a food people are squeamish about eating. Yep.
Spinach.
Spinach! Not there. Gordon, wide open for you.
Octopus.
Octopus! You got it. Are you going to play or are you going to pass?
I'm going to pass.
Pass.
You're going to pass?
Pass.
They passed
pass.
You.
Pass.
Alrighty.
Shut up.
A food people are squeamish about eating. Skip.
A food that people are
squeamish about
eating escargot, snails.
Okay. Snails! Number one. Beautiful. Number one answer.
Good.
Byron?
Raw fish.
Okay.
Good.
Sushi.
I went out with a girl once named Susie. Oh, that was Susie. Yeah, she was drunk, couldn't say her name. Raw fish! Not there. First strike. Three of those that get a chance to steal. Bill, the food that people are squeamish about eating.
Brains.
Ah, that's true. Yeah.
Better be true.
I love brains.
Brains. I say brains,
okay.
Yes.
Now, we've never had a situation where anyone, when we got to the big one question, passed. They may know something in strategy that we don't. Let's take a look. Brains! Not there.
All right.
Mark, a food that people are squeamish about eating. There are two strikes on you.
Well, there can only be one. I love them, but a lot of people are squeamish about oysters.
Okay, I think that's a good answer.
Yes.
Yeah.
If you eat enough of them, you can be older than 70.
Exactly right. Boy, Tuesday was looming up in my mind. Got a couple of barrels of oysters, whether it's up there or not. Oysters? You've got it. You got it, Jack. Three answers left, but only one strike left. What food people are squeamish about eating, sir?
Well, I used to be squeamish about eating it, but I like it now.
What?
Liver.
Liver? Okay.
It's good for you. A lot of people don't like it.
Ever eaten raw liver?
Oh, no! Have you?
No, I just wondered.
We told you we were.
I'm not that mad about cooked. I just imagine I'd really be squeamish about raw. All right, if liver's up there, you're okay. If not, again, it's your third strike. They'll get a chance to steal liver! Not there. Your strategy can pay off right at this second. There are three answers up there. You've only got to give me one. If it's a correct answer, you will play for $10,000. Your answer is?
Snake meat.
Snake meat.
See, they don't like it.
Never mind. Did you have anything else? We got to go with snake meat. Was there any others?
Yeah, we got others.
Okra?
Like what?
Eel.
Okra. Eel.
Eel was when you said seafood, raw fish. We figured that eel would be eliminated.
You're going with the
eel.
Old snake-a-roo.
Kimchi.
Yeah,
if snake meat is up there, you have it, and you'll play for the $10,000. If not, our overall champs will be called a real people. Snake meat! Never believed that before. Number four. Clam. And, frog leg. Now somebody thinks. Number six. Frog's leg. Oh, you had him there. All right, you'll stay in Rudamon, right? Because this is big money now. I need two people. It's going to be the same two. Come on, let's go. The other two. Who'll go first? All righty, you go up there. All righty, little girl. Well, congratulations, you are the champs, and now you're playing for an additional $10,000 for Greenpeace. And you'll let me know when Tim is all ready. Is he ready?
Yes.
Okay, cannot hear us, earphones on. Don Ho singing several songs.
Poi, poi, poi.
You know what to do, just take the $10,000 from us, we'll be so happy.
Oh, okay.
Give me 15 seconds, please.
Thank you. That's for luck,
because we want you to get the money. Nobody talk, because I want to hear every word here. Name the most comfortable piece of furniture in the house.
Sofa.
A musical instrument you pluck.
Violin.
Something more important than money.
Happiness.
A holiday where people give parties.
Christmas.
A color in fire.
I didn't hear
a
the
question. A color in fire.
Red.
Turn around. The most comfortable piece of furniture in the house. You said, disappointing me as you said it. The sofa. Survey said 32. Good girl. Good girl. Well, even if she said bet, I've only got until next Tuesday unless the oysters come. This is the first time I've met her. I had no chance at all. Musical instrument you pluck. You said a violin. Survey said Zero. Two people would have to say that. They did not. Something more important than money. And you said happiness. A lovely answer. Survey said eight. Holiday when people give parties, you said Christmas. Survey said 36. You got 76. I said a color in fire. You said, I didn't hear you. I said a color in fire. You said red. Survey said you got 118. Three in the morning, please. Very good. And you're gorgeous. Go back. Come on now. Let's go, Tim. 82 points away, champ.
All right, here we go.
Same questions I asked Lonnie. You cannot duplicate her answers.
All right.
If you do, I do. You hear this? I say try again, you give me another answer, okay?
All right.
All righty. Please remind everyone the answers Lonnie gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock. This is for luck, because we want you to get it.
All right.
All right, here we go. Name the most comfortable piece of furniture in the house.
Sofa.
Try again.
Easy chair.
A musical instrument you pluck.
Guitar.
Something more important than money.
Success.
A holiday when people give parties.
Christmas.
Try again.
New Year's.
A color in fire.
Red.
Try again.
Yellow.
Turn around.
All right.
You said name the most comfortable piece of furniture in the house, and you said? Easy chair. Survey said? 17. Bed was the number one answer. And I would have chipped in a couple of dollars myself. Musical instrument you pluck, and you said? Guitar. It was the number one answer, Tim. Oh, survey said? 50.
Oh, good. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Something more important than money, and you said? Success. I would have said not having to see moment by moment, but
that's success.
It is success. You're right, Tim. I never looked at that. You only need 15 points for $10,000. Survey said zero. Love was the number one answer. Love. Then a holiday when people give parties. And you said New Year's. You need 15 points for $10,000. Survey said. All right. We'll see you in one second anyway. Give me my t-shirt. We'll be back right after we watch this. Bam. Okay, I want to thank all of my friends from SOAP. They played the Motion Picture Relief Fund. We have $1,000, and thank you for being here. You were marvelous. My babes from Love Boat, thank you. Neurological Center for Los Angeles Children's Hospital, $1,000, and we thank you. Hey. Here's the real people from the Amy Karen Cancer Fund, $5,307, and a T-shirt for me.
Real people T-shirt for Richard Dawson. Yes.
Thank you.
Real people for him.
All righty, and now the champs. They came in their very first time on the show, and I'm really so proud of you. You went all the way. You were playing for the Greenpeace Foundation, $15,322 for WFKRP, the champs. It's all for you. There you go. Did you pass those along? We thank you. Hope you had a nice time. We really love you. Mwah. We'll see you here on the Fuse.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. We'll be right back.